Hello, Hayden here from Pacific Toyota. Just here to run over this 2016 Mitsubishi Triton. Look, a bit before I do so, a bit about us. Pacific Toyota, we run two large pre-owned vehicle yards here in Cairns. This one being my head office and main location at 235 to 251 Mulgrave Road. Across the yard, we stock anywhere between that 175 and 200 vehicles. And look, we sell very similar numbers. We've actually just been awarded the largest pre-owned vehicle operation under the Toyota banner for all of Queensland, and we just took out the title for sixth largest in all of Australia. Across the road, I got my new vehicle and Lexus of Cairns showroom, as well as my new vehicle Lexus service centre and parts department. We're trying to go green up here, so we've got plenty of solar panels on the roof, as well as up on our main dealership as well. Look, the virtual tour is one of the ways we can sell so many cars over the phone. It basically allows us to represent the car in its current condition. Any marks, bumps or bruises, I will point them out. And if they're deal breakers for you, let me know. There might be some solutions that I can come up with. Look, there's only ever ways of bringing things up to specs. So if you have any questions, queries or concerns, just let me know. But I'm just going to start with the front bumper and work my way around. Now, there was one part on the front bumper which I'm about to point out that I just noticed a bit of flaking. Just in that sort of clear coat there. But once again, if you have concern of that, let me know. I'll see what solutions I can find out with management. But just continuing around, another little mark just there on the bumper as well, but nothing too major. At the end of the day, the car is a pre-owned vehicle and is a 2016 model. Looks like there's a couple little marks just through there. Very fine. Coming up to the bonnet itself, there was one major mark that I noticed, and it's just this one just here. Which looks like either a bird poo dropping or a bat dropping. But other than that, other than the odd little rock chip here and there, it's all pretty well looked after. So there's another little mark just through there. Another one just through there as well. But other than that, nothing too major. All in all, it works out pretty well. Looks pretty well, I should say, not works out. Just coming up now to the base of the A-pillar and down. So all very well looked after through there. Got a little bit of a mark just through here, but nothing too major. Plenty of tread on the tyres, so you're not going to be up for a set of tyres anytime soon. Suspension system all through there. As you can see, it's very clean and tidy. Just from looking at the chassis, I don't really notice any mud stains, which is what you'll see if it's a serious off-roader or they've used it for that. So it tells me this has been more of a tourer or a highway warrior, one of the two. But just continuing down that side panel, if I don't zoom in, it's because I can't see any marks, but there is a couple just here, one and two. But other than that, nothing too major. Nope, they're all just dust. It's all very well looked after through there. A little bit of a scratch just through here, but nothing too major. Bit of discoloration in the plastics, pretty standard. If you've ever seen any Triton of 2016, you'll see that's a common thing. Same happens on these black plastics as well, which is your side mirror there. So I'm just going to open the car up inside. So it's got obviously the vinyl interior. It's got a bit of a mark on it, but it's just, that will come off. I just gave it a bit of a wipe, so that's fine. Just needs to be cleaned down. It's all very clean through there. Once again, vinyl floors. Now, there's a couple of marks on the glove box I just wanted to point out. So it looks like they've had stuff stored in here and it's just been rubbing up against it. So I just wanted to point that out. Got the dash mat in it, your center console, automatic gear selector all through there. Seats are all really well looked after as well. It's a real credit to the previous owners. They definitely looked after the car. Like I said, you got the odd little bump and bruise here and there, but it's pretty minor for the car of age and K's. Now, service history, I just want to get to. So it looks like it was a local car to Brisbane, so probably correct in the assumption of it's more of a highway warrior than any off-roader. So service history, the first service was done at 10,000 K's. Next service was done on the 23rd of the 3rd, but they have written down the K's that it was done at. Then you got your 40,000 K service done, 55,000 K service done, 70, and then we did one at 82. So you've got all that service history there in the vehicle. Like I said, privately owned vehicle in Brisbane. We would have purchased it and brought it up here. Just going into the back seat of the vehicle. So once again, all very well looked after through there. Inside the car, all immaculate. They've certainly done well to look after it, that's for sure. Got all that vinyl flooring. So yeah, all very clean through there. I'll just continue around the undercarriage of the vehicle, and then I'll open up some of the compartments on the canopy. So just give you that general styling from the back of the vehicle. I'll just open it up. So it's good to see the seals work. They were just storing in that little gully there and stopping it from getting inside to the rubber seals on there on it, which is handy. It's actually double rubber sealed up the top as well, so you can see that through there. So it's just a hollow canopy, no inner shelves. It's got a little bit of reinforcement on the roof as well, probably for the top racks. You can see that full strength all the way to the roof on both sides, which is handy. But yeah, that's everything there. Got little toolboxes there as well, tow bars on it with your 7-pin flat plug. Also got the rear drawer system to come out, so it's always nice. Let's open that up. Ooh, maybe I locked it. I don't know, I just didn't turn it all the way, I don't think. No idea. I have no idea how that is or whether it's locked or not, so I'll get some photos separately of that and send it through. Back door on it as well, which will open up, as well as the side door on this side. And like I said, you've got that rear drawer system there, which will come out. Just got to work out how to make it come out. Rear suspension, once again, all very clean and tidy. So all very good through there. Just going to continue down the panel work. So it looks like there's a couple little chip marks on it. Come off my finger. That one's a chip there. That one's not coming off. So you got that one there. Very minor. Once again, plastic finishes on it. So just continuing down. Another little mark through here. And a couple just through here as well. All associated around the door handle, which is pretty standard. Keys on keychains and stuff like that. Especially the keys of this, it's got plenty of keys. The car keys itself, it's got two of, so that's the two Mitsubishi keys, and the rest are associated with the canopy. Front suspension and tyres through there. I'm just going to jump on in the driver's side, turn it on. So you got 82,000 k's on the clock, all your controls, Bluetooth, cruise control through there, reversing camera through there, so it's all handy, all through down to your four-wheel drive selector. So while that's running, I'm just going to open up the bonnet as well. Okay. There. Perfect. All nice and clean and tidy. Look, that sort of concludes the virtual tour. If you do have any questions, please don't hesitate to give me a call on 0410 839 933. And if you did have any queries or concerns from the virtual tour, once again, let me know and I'll see what I can do to address it. But thank you for watching.